hundreds of years before.
Wait.
It's never ending.
Peter Pan, vanish.
He hooved and he poofed and sang an eviction notice.
Well, not my problem. Now you all need to turn around and go back where you came from.
Go back. We can't go back.
Father will turn us into bratwurst.
The guy's bad news.
Hey, maybe you can talk to him.
Yeah, hey listen Chief, you're big and scary.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and away from large crowds. Or haven't you read the stories?
You mean the stories that say, I'm a big, bad wolf?
And the stories that say, I'm the wicked witch?
And the stories that say, I'm a wooden boy?
What? I'm not a wooden boy. I have a glandular condition.
Listen here, ogre. I'm going to spell it out for you. You're the only one tough enough to stand up for that no good, flimmer, flagger, fat one.
Alright, fine. I get it. Attention all fairy tale things. I'm gonna go see this frogwood guy right now and get you all off my swamp and back where you came from. Now, this can't be right. I'm all turned around. I took a right at the candy house, past the weird old woman in the shoe, and then took a left at Mary's little house of lamb chops.
Ah! Help a donkey out, would you? I'm being chased by goons!
Ah! Ugh! It's hideous! That's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Shrek! Let us out in!
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die, I don't want to die, I don't want to die!
He's a talking donkey! A freak of nature!
As are you! You insane beast!
Hey, now you're going the right way for a smackdown.
By the order of Lord Farquhar, I place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh?
Boom.
Now this is the part where you run away and don't come back. Now, which way did you look?
Can I just say, that was incredible. Man, they were tripping over themselves trying to get away from you. I like that.
I'm glad. Now why don't you celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Aww. Now there's a shocker.
That's funny. Say, you know something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to G-Lock.
G-Lock. I know G-Lock. You gotta let me show you the way. Sound like a GPS bird.
I'll be fine on my own. Thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not what you know like we do. Hey, didn't you hear what they said? Man, this place is going separate. We need to join forces. Otherwise, they're gonna lock me up. And I cannot go back in the cage. I don't know if I told you this or not, but I spent 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata.
All right, fine. Only because I'm lost, you can come.
Yeah, woohoo!
On one condition. You keep the jail ring to a minimum.
You got it, man. No doubt. Man, you will not regret this.
Too late.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey to stall our friends on a big city whirlwind adventure.
Then when? dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find somebody else to go.
Do you want a princess or not?
Go on.
She's a day's walk from here in a dragon garden castle surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
Do you want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Besides that dragon and lava thing, we'll have to find somebody else to go.
Big surprise.
I shall make Princess Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect king. Guard, take the cookie to the swamp and the rest of the fairy tale freaks.
Swamp? That's the thanks I get.
My people, we are going to get Queen Maestro.
Things are looking up here in Duloc. Just take a look, the things he's cooking up here in Duloc. He likes to cook a model man of mazes, a plan with seven faces. Bum, 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 bum.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up
in Duloc.
Story time. There's a princess in the tower. Oh my gosh, that's
and she's gone back, a torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she were dead, skip ahead, but in the end Rapunzel finds a millionaire. that did make time go by faster.
Oh, you Shrek, gotta warn somebody before you just crack one up like that. Oh, my mouth was open and everything.
Believe me, Donkey, if it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Yeah, right. Don't talk to brimstone. I know what I smell, but it wasn't no brimstone. It didn't come from no stone either.
Hey, look, this should come in handy. Hope it's fireproof. All right, now you wait here, and I'll be back in a minute.
Wait here? You mean by myself?
Unless you'd rather come rescue the princess and slay the dragon.
Oh, no, I'm good, but hurry back. Shrek, come back! Shrek! Shrek, I heard a roar! Shrek, I'm 2 seconds away from leaving here. This place is creepy.
You don't know half of it. Sorry.
Hey, look, there's a new guy. We haven't been a new guy in a long time.
Shrek, come back! There are people! Beers!
Shh, you don't want to wake her up.
She gets really mad. What are you talking about? Who are you people?
We're not. We came to rescue the princess.
Huzzah!
Just like you. None of us made it, though.
We're the lucky ones. Everyone's got incinerated.
She keeps us here because we see backup.
Whoop! Dragon! I'm out of here!
Thanks. All right. Now let's go.
But hold us on to the night. Don't you want to save this moment? It be if our first meeting, it'd be a wonderful and romantic scene.
I'm like a crackpot magnet.
You didn't slay the dragon?
It's on my to-do list. Now come on. Don't do.
Shrek, dragon!
Roar!
Okay.
men.
You're awful chipper.
And why shouldn't I be? It's a brand new day full of fresh promises and fresh starts.
It is?
Yes. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologise for my behaviour yesterday. We obviously got off the wrong foot.
You would?
You did rescue me after all. So, I gathered a basket full of berries and made you each a daisy chain. We've got a long journey ahead of us. To-do lock.
If you say so, come on, follow me.
A road trip! Yes! Pack buggy! Ow! So, tell me about this room to be. Not far put. What's it like?
Well, let me put it this way. Men of Farquhar's stature are in short supply.
Really?
And yet, he's a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
Oh, but very good at small talk.
What are you doing?
I'm just saying you might want to lower your expectations 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me. After a lifetime full of misery, things are finally going my way.
I'm sure it's very difficult living in a dragon-guarded tower.
It was.
It must have been nice to have a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
I'm just saying, you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What, you run out of shampoo a couple of times?
I mean, about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy, are you kidding?
I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles, I had only.
Their essentials on me, cut a hot plate and a chamber pot, and every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation out my window, isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited, I'm very dedicated. On the walls and days were added, luckily those walls were padded.
I always say, yeah.
didn't realise we were so close. Maybe Duloc could wait till the morning.
Morning?
Yes. What's one more night after a lifetime of misery?
You must be hungry. Here, try this. It's a Snodders. They're a little bit like s'mores, but instead of marshmallow and chocolate, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. They just melt in your mouth.
Together. Shrek? Princess Fiona? Princess? It's very spooky in here, and I'm playing no games. Oh my god! Shrek,
don't come! It's me, Fiona!
Princess, what happened to you?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm until you take your love's first kiss and take your love's fall.
It's beautiful. I don't know you wrote poetry.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
Yes, a witch cast a spell on me. So now, every day, when the sun goes down, I turn into this horrible, ugly beast.
Wait a second, this is perfect.
Perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So, I have to kiss my true love. The kiss is the only thing that will break the spell and make me beautiful.
But, you know, you're kind of an ogre and Shrek, well, you got a lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, I think if he knew all this, maybe...
No, he can't though. He mustn't. Not a word. Promise me you won't tell him. Promise!
Okay. But you should. Man, I know when this is all over, I'm gonna need a whole lot of serious therapy.
I can't think about Shrek. Not now. I'm a princess after all. I mean, look at me. Really, who could love such an ugly, hideous beast? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. This is my one chance to live happily ever after. Okay. Good night.
Good morning, Mommy Dove. I've had it.
Shrek, thank goodness, I need to talk to you.
You don't need to tell me anything. I heard enough last night.
You heard what I said?
Every word, especially who could love such a hideous, ugly beast.
But I thought that would matter to you.
Yeah, well, it does. Right on time. Princess, I brought you a little something.
Whoa! Broomstick horse!
Princess Fiona? Lord Farquaad, forgive me. I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, how sweet! But you don't have to waste good manners on ogre. It's like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, will you be the perfect bride for the perfect...
Yes, nothing could make me more...
Oh, excellent! I'll start the plans. For tomorrow, we wed.
No! I mean, why wait? Let's get married before sunset.
Oh, anxious are we? You're right, there's so much to do. Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's code red. We'll be married by sunset.
Whew, there's nothing like a good night's sleep. What did I miss?
Fare thee well, the ogre.
Shrek, what are you doing? You let me get away. Look, I talked to her last night and...
Yeah, I know you two talked last night. You two are great pals, aren't you? So why don't you follow her home?
But Shrek, I want to go home with you.
Me? No, I live alone. My swamp. Nobody else. Especially useless, pathetic, talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah, well, you know what you thought wrong.
Worse, you get evicted from a swamp.
Well, look who it is.
I thought you were going to help us.
Instead, you had us kicked out.
Well, what did you expect from an ogre?
We believed in you.
Oh, grow up.
I won't grow up.
Then get out of my way.
Well, there he goes again, pushing everyone away. Just like it did to me. Just like it did to Fiona. You so wrapped in your layers, onion boy, you're afraid to show your own feelings.
Who's Fiona? Mind your business, ducky.
She's the princess. Who loves him?
Ooh, there's a girl.
Now it's getting interesting.
The princess loves him.
Loves me? She said I was a hideous, ugly beast.
Oh, she wasn't talking about you. She was talking about someone else.
Well, then who was she talking about?
Oh, so now he's interested. A few minutes ago, he was all like, oh no, don't talk to me. I don't need anybody.
All right, fine. I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big stupid ogre, which is why I and the princess can never be together.
Listen up, ogre!
We spend our whole lives wishing. We weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way. But it's they who need to change.
The way they think that is. That's right, Wolfie.
Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down, never.
day to bear witness to the union of our new king and queen.
Excuse me, can we skip to the I do's?
Right, well then, Lord Farquaad, do you take Princess Fiona?
I do.
Princess Fiona?
I do.
Stop the wedding!
Shrek?
Really? Showing up uninvited with your freaky friends?
Ew!
Princess Fiona, I need to talk to you.
Well, it's a little too late for that, so if you'll excuse me.
But you can't marry him.
And why not?
He's not your true love. He just wants to marry you so he can be king.
This is outrageous, Fiona. Don't listen to him.
Once again, he's not your true love.
God, take this abomination out of my sight.
No! I mean, let's hear what the ogre has to say. It might be worth a laugh.
Oh, you are awful. Go on then, ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. You've never read a book like this. But fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down the wall and clear a spot for two.
Until you